many to see, watch it. Please listen the class, because this is a memoir. The background of the author is very important. So shall we go to the text now? In the background you can see the text. Those who don't have the text, you can follow it. Let's begin. I'm from the Okanagan, a part of the British Columbia that is very dry and hot. Around my birthplace are two rocky mountain ranges, the Cascades on one side and the Selkirks on the other. The main river that flows through our land is the Columbia. So she, Janet Armstrong, is talking about her land, where she belongs, where she is from. So I have introduced you to the history of Okanagan in the previous class, and we came to know that it is a part of Canada, a province of Canada, and in British Columbia. And I am from Okanagan, a part of British Columbia that is very dry and hot. Their land is very dry and hot. You can see in the pictures also that I have shown in the PPT. It is very mountainous. The mountain regions are always dry and hot, and during winter it is very extreme snowfall. So they live in a challenging geographical conditions. Around my birthplace are two rocky mountain ranges. So they are living in the valley near these mountain ranges. And the Cascades, so these are the names of those mountain ranges. One is Cascades, and it is a northern part of Washington. North, it is Cascade, and east, northeastern side, it is Selkirks. So on one side, Cascades, and the Selkirks on the other. The main river that flows through our lands is the Columbia. So the river that flows through their land is Columbia. My mother is a river Indian. So her mother is river Indian, means the original people who lived in the river banks of Columbia. So they are called as indigenous, they are original native people of Okanagan, and they are called as Indians. So my mother is a river Indian. They settled around besides the river. The Kettle River people are in charge of the fisheries in the northern parts of the Columbia River system in our territories. So this river where her mother lived is the Kettle River. It's a tributary of the Columbia. And the Kettle River people, so they are called as Kettle River people. So like we have been called Sindhu. Actually the word Hindu came from Sindhu, those people who lived near the Sindhu River. So like that, they are called the Kettle River people. They are in charge of fisheries. So we can see all those people who live in the riversides or oceans, and they depend on water for their living. So these people are in charge of fisheries in the northern parts of Columbia River system in our territory. So they live in various territories of these mountain ranges, and according to the geographical conditions which is provided, they live. My father's people are mountain people. So she is going back to her heritage, her history, her past. They were mountain people. So we know mountain people, we too have Kashmir, and in Kerala also we have mountains. Those who live in mountain tops. These are really high altitude regions, these cascades and Selkirks, and they are very strong. The Leh Ladakhis, those parts, Kashmiris, they are all very strong because they have to survive. They are living in a challenging condition. They have to challenge every day with the nature. So they occupied the northern part of British Columbia, known as the Okanagan Valley. So it is her father's area that is known as Okanagan Valley. And my father's people were hunters. So see how people are depending on the resources around them, natural resources. Her mother's side, they were doing hunting, and her father's family, they depended on mountains, forest for hunting. So they were hunters. So they all were very brave people. My name is passed on from my father's side of the family and is my great grandmother's name. So like we do follow various in some parts it is matrilineal, we follow the mother's history, mother's house, that is important. In some part we follow the father's house rule, father's family. So for them, Okanagans, they follow father's people, and she got her great grandmother's name. So Armstrong, Janet Armstrong is her great grandmother's name. So they are very deep rooted. Their family system is very deep. I am associated with my father's side, but I have a right and a responsibility to the river through my mother's birth and my family education. So she says that even though she belonged to father's side, all her associations are belonging to her father's house, father's clan, she also has a right and responsibility to the river people through her mother's side, because her mother belongs to this riverside people. So they provide for both these hunters or fishermen, they provide education for their children very early. These are all traditional education system, like they hunt, they start learning hunting, there are so many methods for fishing. So she learned both traditions from father and mother's family. So that is who I am. So that is what I am, she says. When I introduce myself to my own people in my own language, I describe these things because it tells them what my responsibilities are and what my goal is, what I need to carry with me, what I project, what I teach, and what I think about, and what I must do and what I can't do. So always her philosophy is that she became a writer, her profession, only to educate her people. Her main objective is to educate the youth of her community and make them proud of their culture. So it is very important for her to assert her individuality, her identity that belongs to Okanagan culture. So it is her responsibility. She believes that she must talk about this. So her people accept her. So her people, my own people in my own language. So she is writing her books in her own language for them, for the people in her village, in her community, to understand what she is thinking, what is her philosophy, what she is writing about, what is her responsibility. So she has these goals. She needs her people to know that she is writing for them. She needs her people to understand that it is her responsibility to bring about changes in them, to bridge the differences of these colors, race or gender, and to evade all those blind beliefs that still exist in their society. And what I need to carry with me. So her people must know what I am, what I am carrying with me, what I project, what is my main goal in front of others, what is I take as my main objective, what I project. So this is how other people who watch you, that is how you project. So her people must know what she projects through her philosophies, through her ideologies, what I teach, what she teaches, and what he thinks about, what I must do and what I cannot do. So these all things my people must know, like all other readers of her. So this is very important to make them realize what she is. The way we talk about ourselves as Okanagan people is difficult to replicate in English. So like Malayalam, it is very difficult to express many of the expressions and nuances of Malayalam into English, because it includes so many cultural bondage that we carried for generations, right? So she tells, the way we talk about ourselves as Okanagan people is difficult to replicate in English. It's very difficult to show. It is very difficult to make a duplicate copy of what she is saying in Okanagan language. She knows both English and Seals, that is her language, Okanagan language. But she understands how difficult it is to, because the culture is very different of that of Englishers, Britishers and Okanagans. Like nammala Mohammed Bashirinte ende Uppaka Rane undarunna novel, when Asher was translating that novel, it was very difficult for him to find English exact words to translate the cultural expressions. My granddad had an elephant is okay, but it never conveys the expression, the cultural something that conveys to the audience. We miss it there. So like that, Okanagan, what she tells in Okanagan language is very difficult to understand in English. We are actually saying, the ones who are dream and the land together. So they talk about themselves as dream and land together. They are not separate entities. They are not separate from their land. So we can't separate these people from their land. Their existence is their land. So they are like who dream and land together. So this is their concept. Like they are so intimate with nature, and they are part of this nature, and they can't separate themselves from this land. That is very important. That is our original identity. She says that is our original identity. We can't change, because that is the philosophy. Each community has a philosophy. Each sect, each clans have their own know, philosophies, their own cultural beliefs, patterns that they can't change. It is their existence. When we talk about Adivasis or the mountain people, they are not ready to come to the plains. They don't like. They want to live there because the nature is part of them. They live along with nature. So they can't separate themselves with where they live. That is our original identity. Before anything else, we are the living, dreaming earth pieces. So this is their identity. This is their identity. Living, dreaming earth pieces. So they consider themselves as a piece of earth. So they are a part of earth. They don't consider earth as something else. So they, you can imagine, they will never exploit earth. They will always respect earth because they are a part of it. They realize it and their dreams are their earth. So living, dreaming earth pieces. Dream is the closest word that approximates the Okanagan. They're like dream is an English word, but there is an Okanagan word that we don't know, but it is very closest to dreams, but we don't translate that word exactly as dream. It is not that dream in English, it is something else, something more deeper, something more connected to the lives of people living there. So so many words that in Malayalam we have, that connection we can't find using another language, right? So as well, namukena cheriya word amma nalla namma concept, it is so different from that of English, because their mothers are different. They don't have this ellam thethichu bhayankaramayittu makkale snehikkunna elmakku vendi ellam cheythu kodukkunna, that concept is not there. Their mothers always work, children live on their own. So such cultural concepts we have that cannot be translated. So dream is the closest word that represents some word in Okanagan language. But our word doesn't precisely mean dream. It actually means the unseen part of our existence as human beings. So it is actually something, some identity that is unseen. So the emotions that we connect with the word is not ഒരു പരിസ്ഥിതിയിൽ നമ്മൾ കേൾക്കുന്നുണ്ടല്ലോ ചില കാര്യങ്ങൾ പറയാത്തതാണ് നല്ലത്. വി കാണ്ട് എക്സ്പ്രസ്, വി ഡോണ്ട് ഹാവ് വേർഡ്സ് ടു എക്സ്പ്രസ് സം ഇമോഷൻസ് ഇൻസൈഡ് അസ്. സോ ദിസ് ഇസ് സംതിങ് ലൈക്ക് ദിറ്റ്, ദിസ് കണക്ഷൻ വിത്ത് ഡ്രീം ആൻഡ് ഡ്രീം ആൻഡ് ഏർത്ത് വിത്ത് എ ലൈഫ്. ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് ദ ഡ്രീം ഇസ് ആക്ച്വലി സംതിങ് വിച്ച് ഇസ് അൺസീൻ, ബട്ട് ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ദർ എക്സിസ്റ്റൻസ് as human beings. They consider themselves as part of earth, and this dream is coming along with it. This is not normally the dream that we talk about in English. So this is very deeper somethings. It may be the mind or the spirit or the intellect. So she is trying to explain it, even though she is not able to translate the exact word for dream. She tells that it is the unseen part of their existence. It may be the mind, so namma manasu nu parayunnathayirikkam, the spirit or the intellect, the thinking patterns, maybe the thinking patterns or the spirit that we call some divine power which is existing inside us or in the nature. It may be that, but something that is a current, that is an ethical current, like we when we describe Buddhism, they also consider themselves as a part of the nature. They don't hurt others, they don't even disturb the animals or creatures. So they consider, like some philosophy like that. We are mind as well as matter. So they don't consider body as a separate entity. The body is a part of this earth system, this mind, this concept that is very deep rooted. So you can't separate yourself from this concept, that this philosophy, it's, you can call it this unseen part, mind, spirit or intellect, whatever it is, you can't separate it from each other. We are dream, memory and imagination. So the body that you see is also your dream, it is also your memory and it is also your imagination. It is not separate. So you cannot describe yourself as you, like the body. Pat, this Armstrong, Janet Armstrong, the person is a dream, memory and imagination of their land. So their land is so very important to them. That is why when this Westerners came into their land for business, they came during 1811 for fur business and they started developing. We know how these developments happen and how civilization happens, and their culture is being lost completely. So that is why she asserts how important for them their dream, memory and imagination is. Is that understood? Are you following me? So, I will...